He may have taught you how to throw a baseball or how to drive a car, but should you take your father's financial advice? I'm going to go with yes for my dad. I don't know about the rest of
us. It really depends, right? Unfortunately, many Americans are facing a retirement crisis because they didn't plan properly. Elijah Kovar joins us with some advice on how to kick some of those bad money habits you may have learned from your father. Elijah, you're not throwing all the fathers out there under the bus, are you? Just giving bad advice?
It depends how much money they have.
Yeah.
Have they done well? Are they setting a good example? No, I'm just...
If dad has a ton of money, then you're probably loving it. It's fine.
Just depends.
Can follow his advice. Yeah, yeah.
So what are some of the bad money habits that, at least stereotypically...
Number one is pretty common sense, right? Spending too much. You may have seen your father go out and spend more than what he was bringing in on an annual basis.
Sure.
A lot of people have watched their parents get in financial trouble, whether that's debt or bankruptcy or foreclosure. How do we correct those habits? Because habits are passed on. So setting a budget, making sure we're staying true to that budget and having savings in place is the first step.
And you say the phrase lifestyle creep. What does that mean?
Lifestyle creep. So somebody gets a raise and all of a sudden, you know, your friend tells you about a new raise and the next thing you see a new car.
Yep.
Right? The expenses on a monthly basis
are going up. The wine gets more expensive. The furniture gets more expensive.
Exactly. Just being careful to watch out and say, okay, how do I fix my expenses so that this is sustainable throughout retirement? Then when I get a raise, maybe I reward myself a little bit, but I take the rest of that bonus or that raise and I'm able to put it away.
Now, what is your advice for people who do maybe get that annual raise? How do you recommend them spending that bump that they get? Maybe it's $3,000, $5,000.
Well, the key is before you get the raise, determine what percentage is going to savings and what percentage you're going to allow yourself to spend. You know, rewarding yourself is okay, but having a set amount, whether that's 40, 60, or however you decide on it ahead of time.
Your last bad money habit is something that we know statistically isn't a problem just for dads, it's for moms, it seems for its most Americans.
Yep. No planning. We see people all the time, they think that saving to their 401k is planning. They think that meeting with a financial advisor is planning. Well, investments are important, but that's about one-fifth of what goes into retirement planning. We need to remember the tax planning, income tax planning, estate tax planning. How do we make sure that we're encompassing all of this into our retirement plan?
And even healthcare too, I would imagine.
Oh, certainly. People forget to build healthcare costs into their retirement plan.
All right. Well, here's to all the dads who are setting good examples.
Yes.
We appreciate
that. Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to you.
Thank you very much.